Joining me is the man leading the push to restore the emergency aid, a key economic advisor to the president, Gene Sperling. Gene, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having us.
Let's start out with unemployment benefits. Some Republicans say, hey, we're open to this, but it needs to be paid for. Others say it just encourages people to stay on unemployment till their benefits run out, and then they go look for a job. And others say, wait a second, the economy is improving. This was emergency aid for the height of the recession, and we don't need it anymore. So why do you think we have to have it?
You know, it is true that the economy is improving, showing more momentum. Unemployment rate in general is falling. But what we're finding is that the worst legacy of the Great Recession is that there is a crisis of long-term unemployment. People who have been unemployed for 6 months or longer are finding it most difficult. And we have to be a country that's committed to leaving nobody behind in this recovery. And so that requires a full court press. It does require more bipartisan effort to create jobs. It requires the president's partnership he's working on with CEOs to give more of those long-term unemployed a chance to get interviewed and hired.
So it's part of an overall strategy.
It is. But we as a country have never over the last half century have we ever cut off emergency unemployment benefits when long-term employment has been this high. Never before. And so, you know, people have to remember that long-term, that emergency unemployment benefits only go to people who are actively looking for a job. For a lot of people, that keeps them, encourages them to keep looking when they're getting discouraged. And I have to point out that tomorrow is actually the day that 1.3 million Americans will go to their mailbox and find that check missing, that check that they rely on to
but
put food on
end,
their table.
I think is a lot of people saying, wow, 73 months, that's close to a year and a half that you can get in some place. Not everybody gets that much,
right,
long-term or not. Where's the, like, when do you say, oh, okay, it's good now?
No, I think one thing people should clearly understand is, first, as I said, you have to be actively looking for a job to get this. And secondly,
that's paperwork, Gene. You know that's paperwork. There are plenty of people that are on long-term unemployment that, you know, can game the system. So most of them do not, and we understand that.
Most of the people are desperately looking
right
for a job. You know, our economy still has three people looking for every job. You know, we saw thousands of people looking for just a few hundred jobs here in Detroit when Walmart put up ads. And I think if you look at why is there a bipartisan proposal now, why did Senator Heller, a conservative Republican from Nevada, support this?
It's because unemployment's really high in Nevada.
Yeah, and he's out there talking to constituents who desperately want to work. But let me answer your question, because it's an important one. People need to understand that emergency unemployment naturally tapers off. In other words, as your state goes below 9%, those weeks go down. As your state goes below 7%, it goes down. And my hope would be is that we'll start getting near the more normal levels of unemployment where we can cut this off. But I do want to stress,
what's normal? I mean, what would
you know? I think as you're approaching 6% nationally,
so 6% would be around the time you would think, okay, long-term unemployment benefits no longer needed. And yet, the president in his radio talk, now more than radio, but nonetheless, in his Saturday talk, said that it's cruel to cut long-term unemployed out of these benefits. They'll still be long-term unemployed when unemployment hits 6%. Is it less cruel at 6% than it is at 7%?
I think I think what we know now is that, again, we have never cut off long-term emergency unemployment benefits when long-term unemployment's been this high. And, you know, this is going to affect a lot of people, Candy. Over the course of this year, 14 million Americans would be affected. 4.9 million would get unemployment benefits cut off in 2014, and the 9 million people that they support. So, yes, I do think we as a country are going to have to take a lot of steps to deal with long-term unemployment. That is the worst legacy of the Great Recession. And, yes, there's going to come a time where we're going to not need to have emergency unemployment benefits, but we're going to have to do more. The president has challenged CEOs to work with him on making sure that the long-term unemployed are getting a fair chance to interview and hire. And we're going to need to do things on job creation. The president's proposed a grand bargain for job growth. He said, let's put together lowering corporate tax tax rates, corporate tax reform, together with infrastructure. That's the type of grand bargain on jobs that we will also have to do, because you're right, in the end of the day, we've got to create the demand and the job growth out there that gives these people who are desperately looking for work now a job to get.